Howdy, folks.
Howdy.
Welcome to the Palace of Mystery. I am Pop Haydn. Thank you. Folks, the line today between science and magic grows exceeding thin. I thought we would walk that thin line together tonight. Thank you very much. Dominic. Dominic is our stage manager, and he also runs the lights and sounds, so you have to be really nice to him or you won't see anything. Folks, you've never seen one of these before, I'm sure, because I made this, and I'm very proud of it. I have discovered something very interesting about the 21st century. Any idiot can go to Radio Shack and buy a bunch of transistors and resistors and capacitors and whatnot, and you can solder them together any way you want. That's what the scientists and engineers don't want you to know. Doesn't make any difference what order you solder those things into. If you put enough power behind it, something interesting almost always happens. This is what happened to me, folks. Quite by accident, I have invented the first practical teleportation device in the history of the world.
Get me on board.
What?
Get you on board.
Would you like to see a demonstration?
Oh, yeah.
Let's do that.
Oh, good. This will be fun.
Teleport him.
Well, we're not quite ready to send people. We do need some kind of matter we can transmit from one place to another. Does anyone have a dollar bill, say, that we could dedicate to science? Who's got a dollar bill? Who's got it? First one up is going to be the one we use. There we go. Thank you, sir. What's your name? Seth. Seth, did you check the serial number on the bill? That makes my job just too easy. Seth, every dollar bill has two serial numbers, one here, they match. They don't match any other bill in existence. So, if I was to give you one of these serial numbers, it would be like a receipt for your bill. There's a volunteer born every minute. We're going to take what's left of your bill, Seth, and place it into our device in this little bit of napkin. And we're going to make it travel from there, Seth, to the ether to land someplace entirely different. I thought, how about one of these large grade A lemons? Can you catch Seth? Excellent. Can you catch this one as well? Look those over. You can keep either one. You get to keep one. The other one I want you to send up to me. Want to change your mind? You happy?
I'm good.
Hold that in the air. Laughed at Robert Fulton, too. They laughed at Tesla. They laughed at Edison. Well, they never really laughed at Edison, but you get the...
No one's laughing.
Did you feel anything, Seth?
I did.
Okay.
Oh, no.
Folks, according to my theory, not only did the electromagnetic radiation cause the bill to break up into its atomic consistence, traverse through the ether, it landed complete and intact inside this limb.
God.
One small cut for man. One giant rip for mankind. Sorry. You try and get them to go before the show, they never had a joint. No. Is that a dollar bill, Seth? Oh, it is. Is it missing a corner?
It is.
It is. Does the corner match the corner from your bill?
It does.
Does the serial number match? I am so disappointed in all of you. What a rotten bunch of scientists you turned out to be. Seth and I could be brothers, you don't know. We could have printed this bill ourselves in Photoshop this afternoon. This is 21st century, folks. Wake up. But this is really magic. I mean, really a science and not some cheap magic trick, like say cold fusion. The experiment is even repeatable under test conditions, should it not? Let's do it again. This time, I'll take the bill. You keep the corner. That's your receipt. I'm going to come over here and find someone.
That's my credit card.
I'm sorry? It's not like TV, you know, I can hear you. This lady right here. You know Seth. Oh, then we can't use it. You know, Seth, you don't have to act so proud about it. It's important that, you know, I don't want people to think you guys are in cahoots. Oh, good. Okay, good. What I want you to do, honey, write your name on the bill in big, bold letters, okay? Be careful. Don't get the ink on you. So I'm going to come up here and say, oh, I'm sorry. Got it? Okay. Now, Seth, to make this even more interesting from your point of view, instead of into a lemon, I thought, how about we put your dollar bill into one of these large, grade A, organic, range-free, cage-free egg. I think that's the dumbest thing about the 21st century. How much range does a damn egg need? Open the pen first. Excellent. And what is your name? Helen. Helen, and you've written it on the bill. Excellent. Helen, you get to pick an egg. Get a good one. Be careful. Yeah, pull it out. Be careful. Don't let it break. Hold it. Careful. Now, Helen. Helen's written her name on your bill, Seth. Can you guys see that? And we're going to take this bill. This time we'll put it into our device, but this time with no protection whatsoever. We'll just put it directly in a tight ball right inside the device, like so. Now, no protection for the bill. Helen? Helen? Helen, are you there? Hold the egg up in the air. Now, Helen, you have had all the children you were planning to have, right? It's not FCC approved or nothing.
Thank you.
Now, it's not going to go as fast this time, folks, because of the lemon juice. You know, it makes it wet, so it's hard to go. You ready? Oh!
It's gone.
There. All right.
Stop wasting my time.
Helen, did you feel anything at all? None at all. It's better if you lie, really, honey. Folks, according to my theory, not only did the electromagnetic radiation emanating from our device cause the bill to break up into its atomic constituents, traverse through the ether, and reconstitute itself entirely inside this egg, but in the process, the entire egg has been hard boiled. Okay, that was wrong. Nevertheless, I have a scientific implement. Which I've kept from my college days. I say I'm not just a college graduate.
Wow. No way. Oh, woo! My God. Woo!
Same bill.
Yep.
Now, folks, there are a few things I would like to point out before I give this back to you, Seth. I will wipe it off with a moist antiseptic towel for security purposes. I want to point out, though, that Seth, this bill has been torn, and it's been written on. It's been covered with lemon juice and egg, and it's a little burnt around the edges, which is a bug we're going to fix before we send people. But the main thing, Seth, is all of these things are felonies under United States law. So I would appreciate it if you didn't talk too much about this trick when you get home. You guys. You're a wonderful audience. I wish I had a better act. But I do. And I get to introduce him to you.